Our opening song this morning will be Be Not Afraid, number 439. And also you'll notice on the number board, number 13, that's the Our Father. So when we say the Our Father, it will be number 13. We're going to sing it instead of recite it. That's on page 26.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you always. In the waters of baptism, Leroy died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In baptism, Leroy received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. Let us pray. Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding. Surround the family of Junior with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated now as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for us to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into our hearts without us ever discovering. From beginning to end, the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to be glad and to do well during life. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd, and there's nothing.
Whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God." So then each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Soon afterward, Jesus journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her and said, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin. At this, the bearers halted and said, and he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." The report about him spread throughout the whole of Judea and in all of the surrounding region. The Gospel of the Lord.
We're all here for the shared reason of a man beloved to us, husband, grandfather, father, a dear friend that is now missing. We gather not just to mourn, but also to remember, because so much of what is good that we still share because of Junior. That familiarity of how so many knew him, Junior, speaks well of him. A willingness to be right in the midst of whoever was there. Not only to love his family, but to also do whatever he could for those who might be in need. A simplicity to be envied. A man of relationships and of the land. One that's unassuming, but one that was always dedicated. We remember those good moments and the strength of the relationship that so many here have had with Leroy, with Junior. And there are signs to us that bind us together here, but I also ask, why here specifically? This church. Why come to the church? My friends, because in addition to the goodness that was alive when Junior was with us and continue to be with us in our memory, our faith also draws us here as a sign of hope. Because our Lord likewise has given us signs. We gather here in remembering the baptism that first made Junior his beloved son. And the hopefulness, especially in this season, of the risen Christ. As we are here in the midst of the Easter candle, that same fire that was first lit for Junior and planted in him, that flame of Christ that now we gather with, is again a reminder of the hope, the shared hope that Junior had in Christ, that we share in Christ, because it is a flame that will not be extinguished by death, a flame of life. And as again as Christ showed in that sign to in the midst of all those people, as we heard in the gospel, a sign for all of them that when he would be risen from the dead, to say to all of them, look, I have this power. Death will not stand in the way for those I love, for people like Junior, that all will be raised. My friends, we gather here for the signs, the great goodness in Junior's life and in the life that Christ plants within us as well. I wonder, when Jesus, when it was told to us in the gospel, when Jesus gave this young man that he had resurrected, gave him to his mother, my friends, that sign, when we meet the Lord in faith, and we are reunited. When Jesus gives you back to Junior, your husband, your father, your grandfather, your friend, I wonder, what will be his first word? The man who rose, that Jesus raised, spoke. We don't know his words. What will be Junior's first action? Maybe to give you a sign of that packet of cigarettes that neither of you are ever going to touch again, right? or it just might be any number of those signs of his love and care that he has expressed to each and every one in different ways. So my friends, we gather in hope because death does not have the last word in Christ. So we take all our signs of goodness and gather them together with one another and with our Lord. My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
For Leroy, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, may he now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, may they share in the joys of God's eternal kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of Leroy's family, may God give you good health and strengthen you with his love and mercy and give you hope in the years to come. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all farmers will be kept safe during this planting season, and that they will receive favorable weather for their crops. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who are assembled in faith and confidence to pray for Leroy may live in the expectation of the coming of our Savior. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ. Grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the offertory.
Our song for the presentation of gifts is Table of Plenty, number 312.
Thank you.
acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Leroy may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Walker, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Leroy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be shepherd of my brother, but only say the word and my soul.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Leroy, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Wish to invite anyone gathered here today to join us in the Church Hall, the Presentation Center. It's off to your left as you go towards the main entrance for a meal and time for fellowship. The burial will take place a little later this afternoon, so please join us for that time together. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Leroy. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in our parting today, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Leroy again and enjoy his friendship. And although this congregation disperses in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
The song of farewell is number 833.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Leroy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Leroy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
In sure hope of the resurrection, let us take leave of our brother.
On a hill. Amen.